Greetings. In this demonstration, we'll show you the details about the EPUB support in Oxygen XML. In the first part of the demonstration, we'll define some transformation scenarios to produce EPUB files from DocBook and Dita. Next, we'll validate an EPUB archive and correct the detected errors. And in the final part of the demonstration, we'll show you how to search for and update specific content in an EPUB archive. First, we start by opening a sample DocBook file. Then we use a built-in transformation scenario to convert it to EPUB, and after a successful transformation, the result is automatically opened in our system's default EPUB browser. Now let's do a similar transformation with a Dita project. We open our sample Dita map file in Oxygen's Dita map manager view. Again, we'll use a built-in transformation scenario to convert it to EPUB, this time using a Dita map to EPUB scenario. Once again, after a successful transformation, the result is opened in the system's default EPUB browser. Note that Oxygen includes support for obtaining EPUB 2.0 or 3.0 output. Now, let's show you another useful feature that allows you to validate EPUB 2.0 or 3.0 archives. Oxygen includes a batch validation feature, so to check multiple files for possible errors, we right-click the folder that contains our EPUB files and select the validate action. Notice that all the problems are reported in the errors panel at the bottom of the editor. Let's focus on one of the files that contains some problems. To resolve the errors, we want to see the structure of the EPUB archive. We double-click the sequence.epub file to open it, and notice that Oxygen offers a dedicated archive browser view that shows all the contents of the EPUB package. We want to see the errors again for this particular EPUB package, so we use the validate button on the archive browser view's toolbar. Now let's correct the errors. The first error reports that there is an element that is not allowed. If we double-click the problem in the errors panel, Oxygen will open that particular resource at the location of the error. To solve this particular problem, we simply need to rename the element. After saving our changes, we validate the package again. The next two errors report some missing resources, and the last warning indicates that the image directory is empty. To solve these errors, we simply need to add the missing files to the appropriate folders. Now the EPUB should be complete, but to make sure, we validate it again, and the validation was successful this time. The last thing that we want to show you is how to search for and update specific content in an EPUB archive. Let's open our sample in the default EPUB browser, and notice there is a toolbar action in the archive browser view to do this. Now, suppose that we want to add the scientific name for the snowdrop flower. We go back to the archive browser view and we invoke the Find, Replace, and Files action. We search for the word snow, and we set the search scope to Opened Archive. Since EPUB is an archive that consists of multiple files zipped together in a package, this means that the search operation will look in all the files within the EPUB archive. We searched for the word snow, and all instances are shown in the results panel at the bottom of the editor. Now we're going to open the table of contents file and switch to author mode. Notice that Oxygen renders this type of EPUB file as a hierarchical list of HTML files, and each entry is a reference to that specific HTML file. So, for our purposes, we click on the link for the Snowdrop entry to access its HTML source file. We add the specific scientific name and save our changes. This will update the actual content within the EPUB archive. Next, we validate the package to make sure it's still valid, and we'll open it in the default EPUB viewer one more time just to make sure that our change was updated in the archive. This concludes our demonstration about the EPUB support in Oxygen XML, and as always, thank you for watching.